joined by Sean Smith, who is the CEO of Eden Research. Sean, thank you very much for joining us today.
Hi, Catherine. How are you?
Very well, thank you. How are you doing?
Good, thanks.
Good, good. So for anybody new to Eden Research, can you start by giving us an overview of what it is that you do?
Yeah, absolutely. Eden Research is an AIM-listed company primarily focused on the development of sustainable chemistry for primarily crop protection applications on a global basis. So we're a company that has launched our first product a number of years ago, which is a fungicide that targets grapes using sustainable plant-derived chemistry. We are in the midst of our second product launch, and we are well advanced in the development of our third product, which is an insecticide.
Thank you. And you've recently made a new announcement. Can you tell us a bit more about that, please?
Yeah, today we announced that we have taken on new laboratory and office space in South Oxfordshire at Milton Park, which is a very large science and technology park just outside of Abingdon, very close to Didcot Parkway. We were somewhat fortunate in the timing, and that as we began to look at the opportunity to expand our capabilities, we identified some space here that was being vacated by, unfortunately, a company that was in the process of downsizing. And so we were quite fortunate in the sense that we had the opportunity to take over the facilities, quite a lot of the existing equipment, consumables, etc., which have greatly simplified the transaction and the move for us, and provided a benefit from the folks that were managing the other company in the sense that they found a home for a lot of their used equipment, etc. So from our perspective, it's been a relatively simple, relatively straightforward move. Importantly for us, this represents a change in our approach to how we do development. Historically, Eden has been geared as very much an IP licensing company, despite the fact that our business model changed a number of years ago. And that's been useful in terms of containing our costs and our exposure, etc. But what we have realized is that there are some severe limitations in the purely outsourced business model. Now, that's not to say we're going to get away from outsourcing certain functions, and there are certainly benefits for outsourcing things in our industry, like field trials, etc. But in terms of the development work, what we have found is that process is quite expensive when you outsource. It's also quite slow, time-consuming, and we lacked adequate control over the process. So for us, the implementation of our own capabilities here at Milton Park is really a key step in our future development. And we'll be able to basically support the operations with analytical chemistry capabilities, formulation development capabilities, screening on insects, plant pathogens, etc., all with a view toward accelerating product development.
And Sean, how has business been for you over the last few months with coronavirus?
It's been challenging. I mean, there's no question about that. One benefit of being involved in the food chain is that basically crops keep growing and farmers keep having problems with growing crops, having in particular fungal infections, etc. So for the time being, we don't see there being a dramatic impact on the overall business. What we have seen is complications with quite a number of different aspects of the operations. That involves things like import permits. It involves things like road transport. Some of the more almost logistical aspects of product production and supply. So it is a bit premature for us to right now call it the time on where we're going to get to with regard to this year. And by the way, we're really just at the beginning of the period during which our products are even applied. So as is always the case, this time of year, we don't have great visibility on how the season is developing. But in initial indicators are relatively give us some calls for optimism, let's say. What we don't know is what the downstream effects will ultimately wind up being as we get toward the end of the season.
And is there anything else that you'd like to talk about regarding Eden Research today?
No, I mean, we're very excited about having these new capabilities and building a team to support us in the accelerated development of our products. It's very nice for us to be in that situation. And frankly speaking, bringing on members of the team that have additional perspective, additional capabilities, and will really contribute to the medium and longer term development of the company.
talking of medium and longer term development, any plans for 2021, looking hopefully past coronavirus?
You know, at this point in time for us, we have a long list of regulatory authorizations that are still pending. And so this has been a clear impact for us thus far this year. Certainly, if we don't get those authorizations done and across the line this year due to constraints of the regulators globally, we would certainly expect those in, if not the end of the year, but to impact 2021.
Thank you, Sean. That's all we've got time for today. Thank you very much for joining us.
Okay, thank you.
And hopefully we'll get to speak to you again soon.
All right, very good. Thank you.